Let's make a reggaeton mix. I make my mixes in two parts. In part one, I create the mix, also called set. And in part two, I clean up the transitions, add effects, and add my DJ drop. This video is part one, with part two coming in a few days. Open your DAW and prepare your workstation. Select the down pointing arrow in the control bar and set the display mode to custom. Import your songs and when given the option, select create new tracks. Delete track audio 1 and start to organize your songs by renaming the track to just the song name. Color assign each track after that. You'll see why this step is important later on in the video. Let's find the tempo of each song. Choose any track. I usually start with the one on top. Press E and select the Smart Tempo tool. Click Analyze. When your track is analyzed, ensure the tempo is set to constant. If it comes back as a variable, change it. To the left, click Edit and select Apply Project Tempo to Region and Downbeat. Select a different track and repeat the same steps until all of your songs are analyzed. Now that we know the tempo of each song, we can arrange the tracks from slowest tempo on top to fastest tempo on bottom. Change the project tempo to match the tempo of your first song. Save your project and name it in the same style as the example on screen. This helps keep your projects organized. Our workstation is now prepared and we can create our mix. After listening to the first song, I like how the end has a beat loop with no vocals, making it easy to transition into our next song. However, at the halfway point is where I want to transition into our next song. So how do we make that happen? Duplicate the track, make a cut in your song before your transition point, and drag it down to the duplicate track. Zoom in to sync your beats up and do a quick check. Quick warning, there are parts of the video where the audio will be louder than normal as we're creating our mix. I will give you a volume warning on screen, but I don't want to reduce the volume as I don't want to take away from the learning experience. Both tracks are synced. Cut both tracks and delete the parts you don't need. It doesn't always work to just cut on the beat. Here's what not to do. That is on count, but it sounds awful. Instead, by cutting a little before, we can hide the jump forward. Use the guide to measure and cut the same point on both tracks. Delete the sections you don't need. I think we can agree that sounds way better. I do want to ensure there is no clipping, so I'm going to fade in the second part of the song instead of leaving the hard cut. We aren't worried about getting it perfect right now, as we'll circle back in part two. Let's listen to the next song in our set. Using a 4-bar transition, we'll mix these two songs. To match the tempo of our project to the next song, open the global tracks editor and mark two points, one at the start of the 4-bar transition and one at the end. Slide the second point up until you see the tempo curve automation point and drag it to the left until it snaps in the middle of the 4-bar transition. Adjust the second point to match the tempo of the next song. I like the halfway point of the next song to mix out of.
No.
like the 4-bar loop, but the vocals on the 3rd and the 4th beat of the 4th bar get in the way of the transition. After some time of trying to get the loop to sound seamless, this is what I came up with. And with our next song. Let's taper in the end and the beginning of our tracks. Again, we don't need to be perfect just yet. Like our previous song and every song going forward, we need to speed up the project tempo to match the tempo of our next song. After listening to our next track, I like the end to mix out of, and similar to our first song, we'll make a cut, jump forward, and fade the volume in. The second part of the song is on count, so let's sync the beats up and blend the tracks together. You'll notice this process is repeated throughout the making of this set. That's not right. Let's try again. Nope. That sounds better. We'll move on for now. For our next transition, we'll complete it in 1 bar as opposed to 4 like we have been. To make the mix smoother, I'm going to cut a little piece of a later part of the song and bring it to the front, which is the transition point. We're on the right track, but that's not quite what we want. I'm gonna try different ideas until I find something I like. We need to fill the gap on the top track so it doesn't abruptly end. We'll cut and duplicate. Let's lightly fade our volumes. That's not perfect by any means, but it'll work as a placeholder. Once again, we'll speed up the project tempo to match the tempo of the next song. And once more, we'll jump to the second half of the song. Let's fade the volumes. Let's listen to our next transition. I also like how a one bar transition sounds here. Let's fix the clipping and fill the gap. Much better. Let's move on to mixing in our final track. For this final mix, we'll go back to a 4-bar transition. We'll cut the last 4 bars of the next song and use that as a bridge. The low end of both of these songs are clashing during the transition. To fix that, we'll EQ out the low end of the top song. Since we're using the end of the song as a bridge, we need to blend it in with the beginning. After listening to the tracks together, it's apparent that the EQ of the top track needs to be adjusted. You almost forgot to speed up the project tempo, huh? It's okay, it's your first day. Unless you watched my other two tutorials, here and here. And which I thank you and appreciate you for supporting my channel by watching my videos. Okay, we aren't finished, but the hard part is done. Part 2 in 3 days. That's awful. That's even worse. I am so embarrassed. Finally.